Se escucha.
Yes, if Claudia reports me what is the problem, I can listen to it and perhaps give her the explanation. She's asking me that for the activities assigned, she has to say that the activities that from somebody of the group, and the answer is yes. She has to talk. About the activities one of her classmates do, well, one of that person does during the day or perhaps on a daily basis. And perhaps she can send me the audio so I can help it. Because yes, the internet is giving problems right now. Let's see. Perhaps somebody else connects today. Something that I am explaining right now to Claudia is that she also needs to work in the platform. Going to show her right now what is it that she needs to do. Let's see, we are going to show her on the platform the activity she needs to perform. Yes, now she got it. Great. Now she knows what she needs to be working on. And let's see. Well, we solved that doubt. Let's see at this time who is supposed to be here. Because it's 10:20. Right now it's Claudia. Jennifer couldn't. Andres is coming in 10 minutes and Cesar is coming after that. Okay, dokie. Let's see who's going to connect. And we will also see how's the connection going. Good thing is that the file is already converting, so we can upload it very soon. Yeah, connection has been problematic today. Okay, let's see. We are going to share something so we can see it. Let's see. We were talking about the simple present. And let's continue talking about the simple present. Okay, we were working with this in the class. This topic was very interesting because the students could like do the exercise answering the questions. They could say who cooks at home, perhaps not the same person the same every day. I mean, could be that somebody else to have cooked on a different day. And what do your parents do in the afternoon? Of course, this question was for little kids. Like, when do you do the homework? Do you have a bath or a shower? Oh, bath. We don't usually have bath here. What time do you have dinner? That's a very simple question. And then we have, what do you usually eat for dinner? Then we have, what do you usually do after dinner? Do you read in bed? And then we have, do you drink hot milk before going to bed? What time do you go to bed? Now, in this exercise, the students were supposed to fill in the sentences with the correct verb in the simple present. Peter has breakfast at 7:30. Do you have to run for the bus or wait for the bus? Paul and Mary go to school at 8:20. Mr. Lewis teaches geography to class 1B. Linda sometimes goes to the library after school. Sam surfs the internet when he writes essays. Does your father have meals at home? When do your parents do the shopping. And another one, my father usually takes a nap after lunch. We visit our grandparents on Friday. Adam rides his bike every day. My brother plays computer games with his friends. I go to the gym before dinner. Does your father do the housework? Grandma always tells us wonderful stories. Does your sister listen to pop music? Does your sister listen to pop music? Tim never does the homework. Tim is a bad student. We have dinner at 9:15 p.m. Mom drinks tea after dinner. Oh, me too. Okie dokie. Now let's see. We are going to stop sharing, and it is time for Andres to come here. We are waiting for Andres. Let's see, today's class was daily routines, activities, practice. Okay. We were talking today about daily routines, activities, practice. That was the topic from our class today. Let's see, and today is 12. Our class today was the video conferencia number 8, and the name was Daily Routines. Activities, practice. That's the name, how my students can check it out on YouTube, which is great. Now we are going to upload it so they can check it and take advantage of the fact that the class is already in. Actually, this is good because I have a student who was telling me that she's already checking one of the previous classes, and that's great. That's excellent. So let's see. Good evening. Hello, Andres. How are you?
Hi, teacher. I'm fine.
Tell
that
me.
Compu
is giving problems.
The internet is problem.
Yes, it was bad. Some of your classmates were reporting that. Carla told me that she couldn't connect. Claudia couldn't listen to me. Jose had a problem. So, everybody. Hey, today I'm sending you the information. Don't worry, okay?
Okay.
So
nice.
Tell me, how can I help you? Is there any topic that you would like me to help you? ¿Hay algún tema que te gustaría que le ayudara?
Sería más como cómo mejorar.
Okay, you want to improve.
¿Cómo se llama? Si he estado bien durante la semana y media que hemos estado en clase.
Yes, of course. Actually, you're one of the students that I see that are like working a lot. And that's very important. Now, remember that it's not easy at the beginning for everybody to be perhaps on the same level. But in your personal case, I think you are doing good. Perhaps something that I could tell you is, how are you doing? Well, in the homeworks, you are doing good, no? En las tareas las va haciendo todas, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Perhaps practice. Do you connect to the platform? ¿Se conecta a la plataforma?
Yes. A veces es back the class or durante today.
So you check out the same class, the previous class. Revisa la clase anterior.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Y ahí contesto la.
Okay. Also, if you get into the platform, también si usted se mete a la plataforma, you can see that for the class that are not taught yet, si se fijan las clases que aún no he dado, hay un video, aparece Mr. José Sainz en esos videos. You can watch them because he's like expanding on some other topics. Él se está expandiendo en otros temas related to the same context, relacionado siempre con el mismo contexto, English for work. Entonces, eso le podrían servir como un refuerzo.
Okay.
Besides that, something that I could advise you is listen to music, watch movies in English, vea películas en inglés, but or TV programs, but if you put the titles, write them in English. Si ponen los títulos, póngalos en inglés. That way, I mean, you are not going to get everything at the beginning. Es mentira que lo va a captar todo al inicio. But slowly, step by step, you are going to be getting the information. Poco a poco va a ir quedándose esa información. And that's actually the idea, that with the pass of time, you can get information. And that happens just through practice. I mean, sometimes the class can feel like tedious. A veces la clase se puede sentir tediosa because we are repeating and repeating and repeating. But that's the only way we are going to quite get the information. Esa es la única manera que realmente vamos a obtener la información que se nos va a quedar. Mostly because we are not little kids. Más que todo porque ya no somos niños chiquitos. I mean, for little kids, it's hard to get it. Para ellos es más fácil because they acquire the knowledge faster. Ellos adquieren el conocimiento un poco más rápido. But in our case, you need to practice. I mean, this is a matter of practice. Practice, practice. It's like, you know, this classmate of yours, esta compañera que tiene usted, Claudia, she's reviewing all the videos. Ella revisa todos los videos de todas las clases. And sometimes, if she got any doubt, she texts me so I can help her. Y a veces si hay alguna duda, nos comunicamos para poderle ayudar. And that's the idea, that you check the information, that you take advantage of the information. And, I mean, listen to music, read. That's very important, read. La lectura ayuda muchísimo. So what you could do is...
Okay, teacher.
Lo que podía hacer es lo que le digo. Leer. Leer este, los textos, los titles en las movies es buenísimo. Because you are listening. Está bien, está escuchando, está viendo la imagen y está leyendo. Quieras o no, usted está haciendo una relación among the three things. Está haciendo una relación entre las tres cosas. Y con el conocimiento que se tiene, poco a poco va conectando las ideas. And I mean, that helps a lot. Son cosas sencillas, pero realmente ayudan.
Ayudan, sí. Sí, porque por lo menos logro captarla. La frase o la idea, y lo que a veces me cuesta es cómo en dar la contestación.
Yes, but don't worry, that's normal. No se preocupe, eso es normal. Usually, I mean,
sí, no, pues.
We read more than we can listen. Leído usted normalmente va a leer más de lo que puede escuchar, y normalmente logra escuchar más de lo que puede hablar. That's normal.
Okay.
Those are basic skills. And with the pass of time and practice, and I mean, lo importante es cualquier duda durante la clase, fuera de la clase, comuníquese conmigo. Si es durante la clase, deténgame. Lo importante con las dudas a este punto, estamos trabajando with the bases. Estamos trabajando con las bases. Entonces, cualquier duda en este punto, it is very important that you tell me so I can help you. Usted me dice, de esa manera le ayudo. ¿Por qué? Porque como le digo, son las bases. Si creamos buenas bases, más adelante esto va a ser facilísimo. Porque el programa es bastante intenso. Okay. El programa es intensivo y se ve muchísima información. Lo bueno del programa es que repite, enfatiza mucho los pequeños puntos que son la base de toda esta construcción, que es Learning English. If I can help you,
eso era básicamente todo.
Okay, perfect, thank you.
No, gracias, teacher.
No,
I will be the informant.
Yeah, no problem, no problem. I will.
Thanks.
Take care. Have a good night.
Okay, good night, teacher.
Bye.
See you tomorrow.
See you. Okay. Another satisfied customer. A little sip of water, and we continue here waiting and waiting and waiting for people to connect. Sometimes love more. I lie awake in the morning, she sleeps in his hands. Let's see, I'm waiting now for Cesar. Cesar should be connecting soon. That's cool, so we can perhaps explain or help on anything. We will be waiting. We are waiting for everybody to connect to the class. Let's see. We are waiting. Today we were talking about the daily activities, and that's very important because we were expanding on simple present. I mean, we are not just saying simple sentences. We are already making conversations, which is great. We are talking about how we use the language in order to express concrete ideas. And as we were working, and the students could see, according to what is in the manual, the daily routines. For tomorrow, we are going to work with daily routines again, but we are going to be more specific. Because they are going to be expanding and not just talking about one person, they are going to be talking about more than one. They will get in groups and give me information. also following the example that appears here, they are going to give the prepared sentence. According to that information also, they are going to solve this exercise, and we are going to make a review of the use of yes, no question in simple present. So there's a lot of activities. I mean, this week it's going to be very, very interesting, because they will be able to give many different ideas to use it. Hey, let's see, somebody is telling me. Couldn't connect. Oh, Caesar. And we are going to rest a little bit from the use of the earphones. A little bit tired, using them all the time. We will see in a few minutes. We are going to finish this conference. At least one of the students could connect. And that's very important, because I was able to help him to solve some doubts, to clarify some doubts. And that's good. Sometimes they don't have that opportunity, the one we have here. That is for them to be like using the English, and not just during the class, also to be using it in these personal sessions where I can help them. Now, we have done many different activities, and the activities that we have performed are related to simple present. The first week we were working with the verb be. And with the verb be, we were working with the affirmative, negative, and interrogative form. This week, we are working with simple present, but with the rest of the verbs. So they have worked with the rules. And that's more, a little bit more complex. But it's great for them to learn how to apply and how to understand everything. So we hope for next week we are going to be advancing a lot more.
which actually would be good. But if not, it's been good. So I'm sharing with everybody here. This week has been a lot of work, a lot of interesting work, and perhaps next week we are going to have same fun, and perhaps next week for these sessions one-to-one, I will have more people connected with whom I can share, with whom I can help, which is actually the main goal of this. I mean, the objective of this is help everybody. So in my 2 or 3 minutes, we are finishing. And let me just do a little something. Because the time has come for me to leave. Well, it's been a pleasure to be here, and we will see next week somebody else. It's gonna be great. Well, it is time right now, so we're going to end in a few seconds this session. It's been my pleasure, and if anybody watches this, have a good night, enjoy, and well, learn, practice. Remember, in order to really, really learn English, the first thing you need to do is practice and practice. A lot, because only through practice you're going to be able to improve and to be able to be good, to improve your skills. Okay, have a good night.